how to print your own money. Hey, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Just imagine that sitting in your basement, all your dreams are coming true. Just think about it, that new car, that house by the lake, the church funding, the private jet, the yacht, whatever you want right there at your fingertips. Nah, forget about it. You have that in your basement, and the only dream or nightmare that will come true will be this one. You'll be in prison. But stay with me, I'll share with you a legal and approved way used by millions in the world today to print money. If you're new here, please hit that subscribe button and click the notification bell so you won't miss our next videos. Don't forget to drop a like after this inspires you. Believe me, I've been doing this for a couple of years now, and I guarantee you it works. If you don't believe me, think of the people who come to mind when you hear top richest people in the world. This is what they've all been doing, printing money. The good news is anyone and everyone can do it if you understand the simple concept. As a matter of fact, you were born for this. Born for printing money, you ask? Yes, that's right. You just may not know yet. Now let's get to the bottom of it. The secret behind printing money legally is very subtle, and you might miss it if you don't pay close attention from here. I've done the hard work for you to break it down to three simple points. Understand them and you're financially good for life. Point one, money is all about value. Point two, anything of value can be used as money. Point three, create value and exchange it for money. Money is all about value. If you've attended history classes in school, then you probably remember trade by barter. A long time ago, before the invention of money currency as we know it, this was the way our great grandparents bought and sold goods, by simply exchanging what they had with someone who had what they needed and needed what they had. If I have rice and I need beans, and you have beans and need rice, you get the point. Of course, this wasn't very feasible for obvious reasons. If I had a one-ton bull and needed your basket of tomatoes, which probably is worth just say 10 pounds of meat, how were we going to do that? I'm not going to slaughter my bull for 10 pounds of flesh. What will I do with the rest of the meat? The point here is that people exchange their goods and services for other goods and services that were valuable to them. Point number two, anything of value can be used for money. If you've been at a gambling table and witnessed a player putting in their jewelries, mobile devices, and even clothes to play when they run out of money, then you quickly understand this point. Value is money, and money is value. You cannot separate the two. Please, you'll forgive my example, but believe me, if poop became rare and valuable enough, I don't know, perhaps from some futuristic scientific discovery, they'll quickly become the new currency. And so every time you go to answer Mother Nature's call, you'll be literally printing money. Isn't that awesome? Well, let's move on, forget about the other. If the idea of money is all about what is valuable to someone or a people, and anything valuable can be used as money, then our final point is point three, create value and exchange it for money. We all know it is illegal for you to try and counterfeit a $100 bill in your basement, but imagine if you tore a random sheet of paper from your exercise book and wrote something on it, then walked out to the street and gave someone that sheet of paper, and they gave you a real $100 bill in exchange for it. What is it you've just done? Printed money, of course. From a random valueless sheet of paper from your book to a $100 banknote. Isn't that awesome? But the $1 million question remains, what is that something you wrote on that piece of paper, right? Why that something could be anything, and that's the true challenge why this being so easy, many people don't print their own money, or most people. One thing is sure, that person found it valuable enough to give you $100 in order to keep it for themselves. You created something valuable for them from close to nothing and paid you for it. So what is your own something that people will find valuable enough to pay you for just inventing it out of nowhere? I hope to share with you in details how to come up with your own something to write on that paper and exchange it for real money and more in our next videos. This actually is a whole course I teach audiences in our workshops and seminars, but I'll break it into parts. We have things like how to find the areas or niche best for you to print money in, how to differentiate working for money, which is a job, and printing money, which is your gift, fertile sectors for printing money, and how to practically go about it, and lots more. But while we are here, this is what you should take back from this video. You can create value by producing or creating something that solves a problem, meets a need, or simply adds happiness to the lives of people, like an autograph. Or still, you can make yourself the value. Think of superstars and celebrities who get tons of money to endorse products with their image. If you make yourself valuable enough by becoming a master at something or just some important personality, even your simple autograph will be worth plenty cash. Did you know that Neil Armstrong's autograph, the first man on the moon, is worth $7,500 and more? And the most expensive autograph ever sold came at the price of a whopping $9.8 million. I'll let you guess whose autograph this is in the comments below. I remember my mentor, Dr. Miles Monroe, once said his publishers told him his autograph was worth $56,000, and that's just about books. Think about it. You put your signature on a ball, a book, or someone's t-shirt, and it becomes worth thousands of dollars. Wow, I'm loving this. In conclusion, let me share a simple money printing story with you. A few months ago, I started a new business with a friend as an equal partner. My contribution was mainly my expertise, counseling, and influence. He was the one who actually worked on the business. After a few months, and the business has become valuable, but was still lagging on my personal objectives for it, mostly due to the non-application of my counsel to the letter, I decided to quit and let him buy my share of the partnership to have full ownership of the business. He gave me $400. Not much, though promising, the business hasn't quite taken off yet. But I was thinking, I just printed $400 by taking someone's business idea and helping them work it into something valuable and tangible. No sweat, no stress. You write that something to the sheet of paper, which in this case was my insights and influence, that someone willingly exchanged it for their hard currency money. Now that's printing money. Think of musicians, artists, sculptors, developers, content creators. These people use their gifts to create something out of near nothing. You might as well just try to print hard currency in your basement. But last time we both checked, that was illegal. So why not try this instead? Your take-home question is this: what value can you or have you created? In my story, what exactly did I use to print $400? Two words: my expertise and my influence. In that particular business field my friend and I were operating in, I'm thinking if I continue to grow that influence and expertise, it might just rise from $400 to $4 million in a few years. I can't wait. Musicians use their singing and playing. Artists use their art gifts. Programmers use their algorithms and code knowledge. Athletes use their gifted bodies. And writers use their storytelling gifts to print money. Put correctly, to create something of value that you and I will happily give them our hard-earned money in exchange for. Wow, that's the secret you should master as early as possible if you truly desire financial freedom and independence. Why do I feel like you should be paid for this? Whatever, we're friends, right? Think about it and let's discuss in the comments below. That's our time in this video. Please like this video to encourage us to bring up the next part quickly. If you're new here, subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos. Please also tell us in the comments which of the next parts of this course do you want us to post first, and feel free to share with us your experiences with printing money to inspire someone. Lastly, if you've been inspired by our content and wish to support us for exclusive content and special benefits, head to our Patreon page now, link in the description. I'm Bodas Jumesi from Wisdom for Dominion. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in our next video.